Green School New Zealand is a holistic, community-focused private school in Taranaki, which opened earlier this year. So how did it so quickly become a political hot potato? Well, it was all to do with $11.7 million of government funding. It caused a storm of controversy and a ministerial apology. Tonight, Tamati, Rimene-Sproat is with the school's founders to find out what went wrong and what the future holds for their passion project.
Tucked under Taranaki Maunga, on the banks of Wakura River, nestled in a bush-clad valley, Green School, New Zealand. Idyllic and peaceful now, but 2 months ago this school was a political hot potato.
Remember the days of the old schoolyard? We used to laugh a lot. Oh, don't you...
I apologise.
We are here apologising.
We are the first international destination school in the country. People don't understand what we're trying to achieve here.
Something that is extremely unique.
To understand that, we have to go to Bali.
Good afternoon, graduates. Congratulations and God bless. Om Shanti Shanti.
Where the first green school was founded 12 years ago by this North American couple. A school in the jungle built from bamboo with a focus on nature-based learning and sustainability.
And right now I'm shepherding some other people that are very passionate about green school through the process, New Zealand.
Those passionate people, the Perretts. Taranaki locals Rachel and Michael.
We have so much to offer here.
10 years ago, they sold their very successful HRV ventilation business.
We packed up our lives and went for a bit of an education adventure to Green School Bali,
where they sent their three children.
What we encountered when we got there was just magical. It was just mind-blowing. And we just saw examples every day of children flourishing. And we could have chosen a really easy path, which would have been to stay in Bali and to enjoy the school there. But what resonated for us really deeply was how happy the children were. We felt we needed to share that with New Zealand and we wanted to bring it home.
To bring what was in Bali to the rest of the world, was it possible? Could we capture the magic? Were we allowed to do so?
And so it began.
We had a significantly busy year last year. We literally had the land and turned it from a dairy farm to a school in 9 months. We're very purpose-driven people when we get our teeth into something.
By far the most difficult and most important project we've ever done.
Now, can I ask how much money you two have put into establishing this school?
No, for us it's not about the money.
You've financed all of it?
All of it.
All of the risk?
Yeah.
That's what
entrepreneurs do.
That's what we do.
A first here in Aotearoa, and a first for the Perretts.
We did sacrifice a lot. We sacrificed the status quo. We engaged in something exceptional, something that is extremely unique.
They had no prior experience in education, but they recruited experience. CEO Chris Edwards.
There are many international schools. I ran the biggest one in the world as it happened before I came here. So I had 5,500 students in an international school in Singapore.
Sometimes it's hard to find something positive to say about yourself.
How does this school differ from schools down the road?
We really try and get out as much as possible and use the classrooms as a shelter.
We're going to let go of those fixed mindset statements.
The materials you see within the classrooms, like they are intentionally different. We really do want the children to walk into our classrooms and see that you can create beauty from something that's reused. So a lot of the waste from the building site, we've then created our furniture from that waste stream. And so that's that challenge to constantly get the children to see that there's a different way.
There's a 121-acre campus here. There's a world of science and geography, trigonometry and geography right here. Our vision for the school is that all our children enjoy a joyous education.
Can I have a look at that one? What's that? Marble. That marble. How do you know it's marble?
Yeah, because it's white.
The school doesn't just look different.
Are there any tests?
We've chosen not to have standardised examination.
From primary through to high school, the kids won't leave with NCEA.
Certainly the teachers know exactly where every student is at in their learning journey.
I want you to come up with three experiences from our caving trip last week.
But it's not the anxiety-based testing that you see in most schools.
Instead of giving you grades for your physics or your maths, you will present to universities or your place of work, wherever you want to go, a holistic digital transcript that records your learning journey in all areas.
All right, so who'd like to go in first?
Me.
Let's do.
So it's an examination-free, nature-based, and co-constructed curriculum. So it is unique to Green School.
But it's the Green School's uniqueness which had them coming under fire in September.
The crystal event, can you clarify what that was and what was actually going on?
We host many different events and we intend on doing that ongoing. So we don't judge.
Is that part of the curriculum though?
Absolutely not. You know, we allow people to have alternative beliefs.
Even if some of those ideas may be dangerous, conspiracy theories in particular.
We don't make judgment on their beliefs.
You know, it's an incredibly varied community, and I don't think people realise that.
People don't really like change. They're a bit afraid of change. So when somebody comes into a community and does something that's so different, they question everything. You know, we're all very normal people.
Half of the 55 students here are international.
The fact that people have travelled all this way, have given up so much, and effectively have joined New Zealand's first international destination school as pioneers has been humbling.
The other 50%, Kiwis.
Two hot chocolates and two chocolate chip cookies, please.
People from around New Zealand are packing up, moving here, just to send their kids to the school.
Well, we discovered the Green School from a friend who attended Green School Bali, and we really love the philosophy.
Aaron and Bridget Murphy run a successful property management business.
So you guys fully packed up, moved out of Queenstown, just yes, so you could send your kids to this school?
That was the sole reason, yeah, absolutely. There's a lot of good schools in Queenstown, but nothing that really fitted the philosophy of this one.
What was it specifically about this school that sold you guys?
I think the biggest difference for me is that they teach love, joy and kindness as a subject. There should be more of that in the world. I mean, we really measure ourselves, our success on wealth, and I think we've got it all wrong. If we could bring it back and give love and kindness to ourselves and others, I think the world would be quite an amazing place.
How much have you spent on sending your kids to this school?
$16,000 per each.
Per so, student.
Yeah. $32,000 for the year.
For the year.
Yeah.
But you believe in the school so much that, that you're staying here.
Absolutely.
That you're committed to staying here.
They say their daughters River and Willow are thriving here.
Have you seen any real change in your kids?
Yep, absolutely.
Yeah, absolutely. In the traditional schooling system, everyone's put in a box. But we're all different. So why do we expect our kids to be the same at the same age, learning the same things? And they encourage them to learn what they're interested in, and then they immerse the maths, the science, the reading, all of that into what is interesting to them. So it creates a real curiosity around learning.
Well, our mission statement is a community of learners making our world sustainable. So the community is a really big aspect.
The Murphys have quickly become part of the community.
And it's not only the kids that have found their stride here. We learn things as well, you know, so we have experienced our own growth.
Aaron volunteers at the local Wākura fire station.
Because I was in Queenstown as a firefighter for 3 years and moved up here and transferred to the Wākura Brigade, and they're a great, great lot of people, and they know me. They know our kids.
Like all New Zealanders, the Murphys were impacted by COVID-19.
You guys took a massive hit over COVID. Your businesses took
massive
financial hit.
We went to zero.
And you guys still stuck and are still here.
Yeah.
Yep.
Well, we were worried. We weren't sure how we were going to continue to afford it.
I think there's also a perception that a lot of people here are very wealthy.
We're certainly not wealthy by any means, you know, but when we've made sacrifice to come here, and so have a lot of the parents that have come here. There's no Lamborghinis in the car park.
Coming up.
They shouldn't be getting a government handout.
We've never spoken about the money.
Do they feel forgotten?
They feel forgotten, they feel angry.
It's been less than a year since the Green School opened, but locals have already formed an opinion.
I think it's been a really cool initiative in Taranaki.
It's just a great pity it's been caught up in the political football.
It just seems wrong.
And it's growing our economy, bringing a lot of work, a lot of jobs.
On the 1st of July, then Minister of Finance Grant Robertson made this announcement.
The next step in our plan to recover and rebuild is being announced today, and that is the $3 billion from the COVID Response and Recovery Fund to invest into New Zealand's infrastructure plans.
The Green School applied.
When you applied for the shovel-ready funding, did you meet the criteria?
We did our very best and assembled a strong application that we were proud and fortunate to have created.
But you met all the criteria, though, in that application?
Yes, we felt we met all the criteria in the application.
To qualify for the funding, projects had to be construction-ready, sustainable, bring regional economic benefit, create jobs, and cost more than $10 million.
And how much did you apply for?
We applied for $11.7 million.
When you guys first applied, was it going to be a grant or a loan?
We approached it from flexibility.
What we applied for was 25% of that to be a grant.
Any application needed to be signed off by Grant Robertson, Shane Jones, David Parker and James Shaw.
We've never met James Shaw.
We've
only met him via a Zoom call.
Right.
We've never been to Parliament.
That was
or
a
anywhere.
Zoom call?
It was a Zoom call, yes.
To lobby for this funding?
To talk about our project and let him know that we'd put an application in.
How did that Zoom call go?
It was very good. It gave him an insight into what we're achieving.
Their application was given the green light.
For the first 24 hours, we're excited.
But the backlash was immediate on the streets.
They're a business and they shouldn't be getting a government handout.
We have, you know, kids out here that need anything, let alone millions. We're out here scraping for crumbs and the Green School is taking a lot.
And mostly from schools.
The amount of money that's been given for the whole province has been given to one untried operator.
Martin Chamberlain, chairperson of the Taranaki Secondary School Principals Association.
This local couple, principal owners of the Green School, are very successful business people, and for them to be given a taxpayers' government gift when they could have gone to the market for a commercial loan just seemed astonishing, and people are still reeling at that. The government coincidentally has given a similar figure, $11.75 million, to 78 schools for repairs, and that amounts to $150,000 a school, which won't do a lot in some schools.
He's also the principal of this school.
Did this particular school apply for any of the funding?
We did. We put in for an event centre come gymnasium project.
And was it successful?
No, it wasn't.
Do you feel like this particular school is being treated differently?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Does the buck stop then with the government?
The Green School went fishing and they've hooked something, but the government never should have allowed that to happen. So it's a governmental mistake.
What damage has this done to the morale of the schools here in Taranaki?
A lot of damage. It's made them feel undervalued.
Do they feel forgotten?
They feel forgotten. They feel angry.
Why do you think there was so much backlash?
So a lot of misunderstanding is about the fund and what the purpose of the fund was.
There was a gem planting ceremony held at the Green School. Well, the government's just added a bag of diamonds to that.
Meanwhile, the backlash hit Parliament.
I announced as Associate Finance Minister that the government would support a shovel-ready construction project at the Green School in Taranaki. The decision that I made to support this project was an error of judgment for which I apologise. If I was making the same decision again, I would not support the project.
Did you know that at the time that the Green Party policy was no public spending on private schools?
No, we didn't.
No, we did not.
No.
Was that a topic of discussion? Did that come up at all?
No, it didn't.
Why do you think James Shaw apologised?
We don't speak for James.
He said that if he had another go at it, he probably wouldn't fund it. How does that make you guys feel?
Disappointed.
And where will that funding be going?
The funding goes 100% towards the construction industry.
And what exactly will you be building?
So we're adding two more class learning spaces, an innovation hub, a playing surface for a gymnasium, a toilet block, and a visitor's toilet block as well, and a community centre.
How many jobs will this project create?
Yeah, so it's more about how many jobs it influences. With all subcontractors and different labourers, it affects approximately 200 jobs.
Once the project is done, the school says the role can grow to 250, contributing $43 million annually into the local Taranaki economy.
When Neil Holdham, who's the mayor of New Plymouth, came to see me about it, he introduced me to the couple who have started the school. And so we did talk about it, and the mayor was quite keen for it to proceed.
Sunday has approached New Plymouth Mayor Neil Holdham, who advocated for the Green School in their application, for comment. He declined. He has previously stated, though, that he believes the school will bring significant positive economic benefits to the area. He also accepts that many schools in Taranaki are struggling from long-term systemic underfunding.
The New Plymouth District Council says it was not involved in the funding application. Back in town...
Well, James Shaw's an honourable man, and they're coming to town as part of damage control, but the harm's been done, and my issue would be more with the major political partner, the Labour Party, and Minister Hipkins, Minister Robertson, who should have seen this one and cut it off.
3 weeks before the election, the Green Party called a meeting with principals.
Minister Shaw, firstly, how was the mood of the meeting? Were they angry?
I think it was more sort of frustrated, you know, after years and kind of disappointed.
And did you apologise?
Yes, I did.
How did that go down?
Look, they really appreciated it.
Principals were angry that the government hadn't spent money on its own asset. There's this weeping need around the place with poor infrastructure in schools, and the principals have become so frustrated with fighting a property battle rather than getting on with child's well-being.
But the money is still going to the Green School?
Yes, there's no reverse gear on this one. But what we would now hope for is that there's another group in the Treasury deciding on whether it's a grant or a loan, and hopefully this will be a loan.
And how would you feel if it was 100% loan?
We would be fine with that.
And just last week, a decision on that. The $11.7 million is to be 100% government loan.
We really want people to come and visit and see it, because it really is the only way to get a true understanding of what we're trying to achieve, because it's so unique.
If you want to know about Green School, come and visit Green School.
This is like our gift to New Zealand.
And construction on the new phase of the school will commence in March.